Welcome to today's class. Hope you all are fine and you are taking necessary precautions. We have already started. Language of chemistry. This chapter is going on. So today we will continue this chapter, molecular formula. This topic we were doing in our previous classes, and today we will continue. We will start with this only. Okay, we will continue this chapter, this topic. But before that, I want to tell you something about the project which is already given. So the last date, I told you to prepare it by 10th of August. So I'm just increasing the date. So by this week, you can finish this. Okay, so after the end of this next week, you have to finish it. Okay, so you are getting some more days to do this. And as I told you before, you have to do it in a chart paper. Many of you are having some confusion regarding this, how you have to do, and whether you have to do it in a copy or not. So I told you, as I told you before, in a chart paper, in a big chart paper, just like a date calendar, you have to prepare it, and so that you can hang it in your study room. Okay, so in that manner you prepare it, and you are getting the next week also to prepare this. By the end of this next week, you have to prepare it. Okay, hope now no more confusion is there regarding the project work. And how you have to do this project, in our previous class I told you, I think in just after the I can't remember the date, I think just after the our unit test gets over, the first class which I got, in that class I have discussed about the project. Okay, so if you are having some doubt, again you can go through the class. You just do the class, you just see the video of that class once again. Okay, so let's start molecular formula. So this thing, this this part, you have to several times you have to practice. Okay, new formulas are there. So these are totally new for you, and so this need a proper practice, otherwise you can't remember the formulas. Okay, so do in that manner. In your textbook, there are some molecular formula of some common compounds which we have done already, and few are left, so that we are going to do today. So the formula of sodium bicarbonate, this we have discussed earlier in our previous class, that whenever you are writing the molecular formula, you are writing the name of the compound, the first letter will be capital always, and the second part of the, there are two part of a molecular formula if it is a ionic compound, like sodium bicarbonate, this is an ionic compound. So here two ions are there, two radicals are there, one is Na plus, another is bicarbonate ion, that is HCO3 minus. Okay, so these two parts are there, this is positive part, this is the positive radical, and this is the negative radical. So the positive radical and this is the negative radical, two parts are there, or this is the metallic part, we can say, as sodium is the metal, so this is the metallic part or metallic radical also we can say, and this is the non-metallic part or non-metallic radical. Okay, so for all the molecular formulas, all the ionic compounds, we can get this kind of two parts. And the second part, as I told, the first part will start with the capital letter, and there will be a gap between these two parts. You can see there is a gap between sodium and bicarbonate, and this bicarbonate will start with a small letter. So this we have to follow in each and every formula. So sodium bicarbonate, if it is a ionic compound, okay, so sodium bicarbonate, this is the formula of sodium bicarbonate. Sodium is Na plus, we know this is the radical, so Na HCO3, okay, HCO3 minus, this is the bicarbonate radical, so carbonate is CO3 minus, carbonate is CO3 2 minus, okay, and bicarbonate means, or this we can call as hydrogen carbonate as well. So sodium bicarbonate or sodium hydrogen carbonate, both are same compound only. So when we are introducing one hydrogen here, H plus, with this carbonate, so H plus plus CO3 2 minus. So this is hydrogen ion and this is carbonate ion. So when these two will combine together, it will form bicarbonate or hydrogen carbonate. And now this is the positive charge. One positive charge is there with hydrogen ion, and two negative charges with one carbonate ion. So one positive and one negative charge will cancel each other, and we are left with one negative charge. So this will be the formula of bicarbonate radical, HCO3 minus. In the same manner, we can get bisulfate, bisulfide, this kind of radicals. Okay, so this is sodium bicarbonate. Next, potassium carbonate. In the same manner, potassium carbonate, the C will be small only. So here we are getting the positive radical as K plus potassium ion, and here instead of bicarbonate we are having carbonate as negative radical, so CO3 2 minus. So as we have learned, we need to cross the valencies. So here K plus means valency of potassium is 1, and carbonate CO3 2 minus means its valency will be 2. So we need to cross the valencies. So this 2 will go to potassium and this 1 will go to carbonate. So what will be the formula? K2CO3. So as 1 is there with carbonate, so no need to give this bracket. Okay, if we write in this manner, we can understand this whole valency of potassium, this will be with this whole carbonate ion, CO3 minus. Okay, CO3 2 minus. But as this is 1 only, so no need to give this bracket and no need to write 1 as well. So only K2CO3 will be, in this manner we will represent the formula of potassium carbonate. Okay, and this is acha another why we are crossing the valencies. For that we have to understand that this is the reason behind whichever formulas or whichever compounds we are getting, all are without charges, means all are
neutral. So how it will be neutral? If we calculate this, if we calculate the charges for let us take the example of potassium carbonate only. Why we have to cross the valences during writing the molecular formula? See, in potassium, one positive charge is there. So we know that any compound it will be electrically neutral. Okay, so one positive charge is there with potassium, and there are two negative charges are there with one single carbonate ion. Now if we only write KCO3, then we are having one negative charge with us. Okay, one positive and one negative charge will balance each other, cancel each other, and we will be left with one negative charge. But this cannot happen, because always we have to we will be getting the substances, we will be getting the element, we will be getting the elements, or we will be getting the compounds as electrically neutral. So how we will be getting that? If we just, this is one negative charge and this is one positive charge and this is two negative charge. So if we multiply this with two, then it will be now equal. This is two positive charge and here two negative charge is there already. So if we see from this, easily we can get that we need to balance the two negative charges of bicarbonate. We need two potassium ions. Okay, two potassium ion will balance one carbonate ion. That means we need 2K plus to balance one carbonate ion. So here we can see easily that two potassium ion can balance one two potassium ion. The charge of two potassium ion will be two positive charge, and this can balance one negative charge of carbonate ion. That's why we need two potassium and one carbonate. So this you can see in each and every case of the ionic compounds. Okay, just to balance the charges, just to make the compound neutral, electrically neutral, we have to multiply whatever we need to do to balance the charge, to make the compound neutral. We have to do that. Okay, and that only we are doing during the formation of the molecular formulas and all. So K2CO3, this is a electrically neutral compound. Achha, next, see calcium carbonate. For that also we can see the same thing. So here instead of potassium we can write calcium. Achha, let me write it first. Calcium carbonate, this is small only, huh? Calcium carbonate. Okay, this is the main ingredient of marble or chalk. So if it's given that write the molecular formula of marble, then also it will be potassium calcium carbonate. Or if it is given that write the molecular formula of chalk, then also you have to write the molecular formula of calcium carbonate. So here also two parts are there. Calcium, we know this is Ca2 plus, that means it's having two positive charges, and carbonate, as we have done earlier, CO3 2 minus, so two negative charges. So here already it is balanced. So 2 unit of positive charge and here 2 unit of negative charge. That's why no need to multiply with any other numerical value and all. So easily if we write here, see this is 2, both are 2. So only side by side we have to write down the symbols of the radicals. Okay, so CaCO3 will be the formula, molecular formula of calcium carbonate, CaCO3. Okay, next, copper sulfate. Copper sulfate. Copper can show variable valency +1 and +2, but in copper sulfate it's having valency 2. Okay, so copper 2 plus and sulfate is, we know, SO4 2 minus. So here also the charges are in balanced form only. So 2 positive charges and here 2 negative charges, 2 unit of negative charge. So just as we have seen before for calcium carbonate, here also we have to write side by side. CuSO4 is the chemical formula, molecular formula of copper sulfate, CuSO4. Okay, so in both the cases this 2 will be there, and as both are same and we need to take the least value, so this will be CuSO4. Okay. Okay, next, iron sulfate. Now, in this iron sulfate, it can be of two types. Iron can show valency of, iron can show two type of radicals, variable valency. One is iron 2 plus and another is iron 3 plus. So both we will be doing. So iron sulfate, if it is written iron 2 sulfate in this manner, Roman, in Roman we will be showing the valency of the metal. So here, as after iron we have written that 2, Roman 2, that means we are taking the iron 2 plus. Okay, iron 2 plus radical is involved in this molecular formula of this compound. Okay, so iron 2 plus only. And so as both are 2, so Fe2SO4 whole 2 we can write. Okay, just we have crossed the valencies, and now as both are 2 we will be removing this, and just side by side we have to write this radicals. Okay, iron, the formula or the symbols of the this 2 unit. Okay, FeSO4. Now what will be the formula if it is iron 2 sulfate, if it is iron 3 sulfate? That means this iron 2 sulfate, another name is there for this, as it is the lowest valency of iron, so it is called ferrous sulfate. Ferrous and ferric, eek and us, these two are there for variable valencies, so this is also called ferrous sulfate. Iron sulfate and ferrous sulfate both are same compound. Next, if iron 3 is involved in the compound, the formation of the compound. Okay, so Fe3 plus, and here SO4, 2 minus sulfate will be the same sulfate only. So for that we have to, again, as the valencies are not same for positive and negative radicals, so let us cross the valencies. So iron and sulfate, SO4 2 minus and iron 3 plus. So valency of iron is 3 and sulfate is 2. We have to cross it. So from this, this 2 will go to, 2 of sulfate will go to iron and 3 of iron will go to sulfate. You can notice that as with this is not one or some other numerical value. So here we have to give the bracket with sulfate. Okay, so Fe2SO4 whole 3. This valency of iron will go with the whole unit of the sulfate, which is SO4. So we must give a bracket here. Iron sulfate. So this will be Fe2SO4 whole 3. Now, from this, we can verify whether it is neutral or not. For one iron, we are getting 3 positive charges. Okay. And from one sulfate, we are getting 2 negative charges. So it is not balanced, it is not neutral. And from the formula, we are getting that we are taking iron 3 plus iron. Okay. So this will be multiplied with 2, because we have taken 2 Fe2 means we are taking 2 iron 3 plus iron. Okay. 2 iron 3 plus radical. So 2 into the charge of one single iron 3 plus. And here 3 unit of SO4 ions are there. So here we have to multiply this with 3. Now if we calculate this, 2 into 3, that means 6 unit of positive charge. And here 2 into 3, that means 6 unit of negative charge. So it is balanced. So this is the verification that this compound is neutral. This iron 3 sulfate can be called as ferric sulfate also, as this is the highest valency of iron. So ferric, and we can call it as iron 3 sulfate or ferric sulfate, and this is iron 2 sulfate or ferrous sulfate. So eek and us, this is the difference. The lowest valency, for lowest valency we will be using the us, this, and for highest valency we will be using the eek. For all the variable valencies, for all radicals variable valency, we will be using the same. For copper it is cuprous and cupric, this we will be using. Okay, next, sodium hydroxide. This we have done already in our previous class. Calcium hydroxide. What will be the formula of calcium hydroxide? Calcium hydroxide. Hydroxyl group is OH minus and calcium is Ca2 plus. So to balance it, we need 2 hydroxyl groups. So the formula will be CaOH whole 2. Okay, calcium hydroxide. Next, ammonium hydroxide. So I'm not writing the name now. You can understand. Ammonium is NH4 plus and hydroxide is OH minus. Okay, so both are having one unit of positive and negative charge. So just side by side, we have to write down this. NH4OH will be the formula of ammonium hydroxide. This is ammonium hydroxide. Hydrochloric acid, or this is called hydrogen chloride also. Okay, hydrochloric acid. There are three main acids: hydrochloric acid, nitric acid, and sulfuric acid. This nitric acid can be called as hydrogen nitrate. Okay, hydrogen nitrate, and or this is called hydrogen nitrate, and sulfuric acid can be called as hydrogen sulfate. Hydrochloric acid, this is called hydrogen chloride also. Its formula will be HCl. H plus and Cl minus both will be there, so HCl. Nitric acid or hydrogen nitrate, we know formula of nitrate is NO3 minus. With this one hydrogen ion will be there, so H plus NO3 minus. So both are 1 1. They are having valency of, both are having one valency, so it will be, formula will be HNO3. Okay, hydrogen nitrate, that's why it is called hydrogen nitrate. So sulfuric acid or hydrogen sulfate, sulfate we know SO4 2 minus. So to balance one sulfate ion, we need two hydrogen ions, because with one hydrogen ion there are 1 unit of positive charge. So to balance the 2 unit of negative charge of sulfate, we need 2 hydrogen ions. So 2H plus and SO4 2 minus. So how we will be writing this? H2SO4. Okay. So H2SO4 is the formula of hydrogen sulfate or sulfuric acid. Next, acetic acid. This is another acid, and this is an organic acid, mild acid. All organic acids are generally mild acids, weak acids. So its formula is CH3COOH. Okay, this is acetic acid. Here we are having two radicals. One is acetate radical, that is CH3COO-. This is the negative part, and hydrogen ion, this is the positive part. So CH3COO-, this is acetate radical, and H plus is the positive part. So acetic acid, formula of sugar . This is C12H22O11. Okay, and formula of glucose, here 6 carbon are there, C6H12O6. Okay, so glucose is the there will be 2 glucose molecule in 1 sugar molecule, only there will be 1 less water molecule. Okay, so how we will be getting that? C See, if we double this, we are getting, if we double the glucose, then we are getting 2 into C6H12O6. So this is C12H24O12. So if we minus one water molecule from this, that means minus H2O, if we do, then we are getting C12H22O11. So there will be two less hydrogen molecule from this. So 24 minus 2, that means 22. And for oxygen, 12 minus 1, so 11. So this is the formula of sugar. Okay.
So here I am ending our today's class. You learn these formulas, practice it properly. Several times you have to practice, because you can understand very well that these are new to you all, and these are not so easy to remember. Okay, so if you divide the radicals, if you just don't blindly memorize these things, because this will not work only. So you divide, as we have learned this, you divide the radicals, you divide the positive and negative part, and then you learn. Okay, you understand why this formulas are being like that. So if once you get the formula, once you get the way why how the formulas are constructed, then you can easily construct new formulas also, which are not which you have not done earlier and all. So if you know the radical formula of the radicals with their charges, that means with their valencies, then easily you can construct new formulas of the compounds. So in that way you have to learn it. Okay, so do in that way. So till then, just be safe. Have a good day.